I haven't turned on this camera in a very, very, very long time. Wow. But I haven't really picked up this camera, one, because I've been sick so much in the last 6 months. Like, it's been crazy. I got my gallbladder removed. I had gallstones at 24 years old. Gallstones? I had to reflect a lot of my decisions. I had to start diving a little bit deeper into why I'm doing the things that I'm doing if I'm not benefiting from it. Fania, you want to make better decisions for yourself? It starts with making better decisions for yourself. That's like, it's very hard, because if I had to choose between, you know, a burger and some apple slices, I naturally want to lean towards burger. Even though I think about the after effects, I'm gonna feel heavy, I'm gonna feel bloated, I'm gonna feel less energized, fatigued, like I just wanna go to sleep right after. The itis, or sometimes the itis is good, don't get me wrong, good itis after Thanksgiving, ooh, awesome. Itis during the middle of the workday, not so awesome. So it's like retraining my mind, or unlearning a lot of what I thought I liked previously, even though every single time I indulged in those things, I felt shitty, I felt terrible. And that's just where I'm at now. So it's really walking in this discernment. Yeah, I'm about to go to sleep. I'm finally starting to vlog. Today is actually Wednesday, but it's Thursday now because it's 12:08. It is Juneteenth weekend. I'm really excited. This weekend, I also got to get a relaxer because my hair is not like cooperating with me anymore. I got a relaxer in February, so I'm hitting 4 months now. So this is the point where a lot of shedding is happening. I wish I could have gotten relaxed for like maybe 1 or 2 weeks ago, just to avoid all the shedding that's happening. So yeah, I need to go to sleep because I got work in the morning. Okay, bye. Good morning, folks. It's so crazy how there are so many things aligned in my life right now. Like, not gonna lie, going through all of like, this necklace is not doing it for me. I don't even know why I threw it on. I feel like maybe something daintier. Daintier necklace works a little bit better. I forgot to grab my cardigan. So what I was basically saying is how there's so many things aligned where it, like, the message that I need to be doing, or what I need to be doing, or what I have been doing, and how is it working for my good? Like, all the pain that I've been through in the last 6 months, and really trying to heal myself and make better decisions for myself so I don't go through all that pain anymore, is really just like healing a lot of different beliefs about myself, of like, I can't be healthy because I like good food too much. No, girl, like, it's just making choices, better choices, thinking that, like, I am literally able to make this choice for myself. It's not what I'm normally used to or what I was taught to like, but I'm trying to listen to myself, my inner voice, because she shrank. She shrank so goddamn much. But we are building her up. We are building her up, you know? I feel like the alone time that I've had, especially with being sick, and it isolated me just a little bit more from people, was necessary, because, like, I realized there's so much shit that I don't like. So much. But I'm not gonna say pretending to like it, but I was tolerating it because of X or Y reason. And those reasons were not a strong enough motivator anymore for me to be tolerating bullshit and putting myself through bullshit. So I'm in the process of literally evaluating all of my choices in the last 6-7 months, year actually, slash going back to a lot of thoughts or beliefs from my childhood that are playing a role now, especially around like health, around money, around like interacting with people and things. So I'm working on it, and I love it because I just watched a video that my sister sent me, love her for that, about, you know, how creating a different lifestyle based on an abundant mindset. And it's like I was doing that work already, so seeing the video and watching it, and I'm like, holy shit, that's what I'm doing already. Like, I'm finna get my life together because I can't keep starting over. It's the reason why I keep starting over, the reason why I keep retreating after doing one thing, because it doesn't fucking feel right. If it doesn't feel right, I don't want to do it. And the reason why it didn't feel right is because the foundation was motherfucking broken. And on that note, I'm finna go because I'm finna miss my train to work. Is anyone some? Beyonce is coming. Beyonce. I just got home from work. It's really dark outside. Like, my apartment looks so dark right now. But Beyonce is coming. Listen, Beyonce is the only woman in the world that can get me to buy a box that I don't even know what's in it. And I'm gonna tell y'all that, like, to be honest, I'm not a person that falls into like the hype of celebrity or falls into the hype of, like, you know, having to listen to something or buy something right then and there the moment it comes out. I don't really care. I know I look greasy and stuff. I literally just came from slaving all day. Ignore it. But Beyonce, let's talk about it. She is literally the only singer where I am completely enthralled. Like, and then to call it Renaissance, listen, music is about to take a turn. She's about to shift music yet again. And you know what? Like, I've never claimed the Beehive. I've never. But the fact that I bought a box, I did. I bought Pose number 2. You know, like, so at least I know somebody who got each box. I was this close to buying all 4 boxes. But I was like, calm down, don't do that. And I'm actually really excited for it. And then on top of that, Coachella tickets go on sale tomorrow, and I don't know if I'm gonna buy it again, like, or go through that whole process again. I don't know if my bank account can handle it because I got my birthday next week. Like, or next month. Which, planning has started with that. It's in the execution phase now. Hoo child, there's so many things. But Beyonce is coming. Wow. So, what we about to do for the rest of the night, I am about to wash my hair because I am planning on getting a relaxer this Saturday. And my boyfriend left honey buns here. I don't know why he would do that when he knows I'm trying to eat healthier. Man, like, why would you bring this here? I'm finna eat one because, you know, if you heat it up, it tastes real good. So I just washed my hair because, like I said, this weekend I'm finna get a perm. It's Thursday, so my hair should be fine by Friday. Tomorrow, I'm gonna grease my scalps or whatever. I'm looking up L-glutamine benefits. So it's good for your gastrointestinal system and immune health. Apparently it helps with, like, not being bloated. I need to go find my eyes. I have no idea where they are. So I'm gonna just look like a grandma squinting. So it's early right now. It's like 8:30. It's Saturday. And I am getting ready to go get a relaxer because this hair, Vivian, You ready to see it? Ah! You see this new growth? And it's longer in like the middle. I think around my edges and stuff, they've been like dealing with some difficulties. Yeah, so what I'm about to do is grease this little scalp because I don't really trust the people in the salon to do it well enough to not burn me. So I'm about to put Vaseline all over my head. Gotta listen, I am gonna pack it on. Cause y'all not finna burn me. Y'all not. That's not what's gonna happen. I refuse. I have greased my scalp. I look literally insane, but you know what? I don't care.
Trim needed. Okay, we are back.
You see the shine? Do you see the shine, baby? Yeah, we're here fresh off the crack, fresh off the presses. I know I look greasy. I walked home. It was like a 25 minute walk home. I didn't mind because honestly I paid monies to do my hair. And I was like, I'm not paying for an Uber back. And I kind of wanted to stop by this deli shop that's near my house. It's actually sick how much I have not explored around my house. There's like so many different food spots. And I don't go to them. So today we tried Little Food Studio. And a little watermelon mint lemonade. Very much good. Wait. Let's talk about my hair really quickly. So, this time around, so you saw this morning, I greased the hell out of my scalp. I literally dipped my head in Vaseline because I don't like to get burned. I've gotten burned one time, or maybe twice. One time in my, like, the really bad burn in, like, seventh grade, and I will never go back. So yeah, when she like parted my hair, right? She was like, wow, it's like really oily. And I was like, I know. I did that on purpose because I am scared of getting burned. And she was like, well, it's not gonna take. And I was like, well, I don't need it to take bone straight. Honestly, I don't even like my hair bone straight because it's so flat and dead. But like, come on. She's giving what she needs to give right now. And grew a lot. But after I said I'm scared of getting burned, she was literally so gentle with me. Like, so gentle. And I loved it. Because normally Dominicans, if you know, if you've gone to a Dominican salon, you know. They is not gentle. That is not one word I would use to describe stylist at Dominican salons. It's not gentle, baby. But she was, and she kept like apologizing, and I'm just like, girl, you're not doing anything to me. Like, you're totally fine. And then when we got to the blow drying part, I saw that she was like styling it and whatnot. And she was like, honestly, you don't need to flat iron your hair. You just got a relaxer. You are good. Okay, so this is just blow dried hair. No flat iron. No flat iron, baby. I'm so proud. It was looking rough this morning. It was.
Let's see what it's giving.
But I'm gonna eat. I'm gonna eat right now. So, and later I'm gonna get ready because I'm going to a barbecue that my boyfriend's aunt is hosting. I have met the aunts before, but like, always being around the family, I'm always so nervous because I'm just like, oh my gosh, like, I'm around your family, and like, what if I say or do the wrong thing? Ah. But they love me. They're super sweet. They love me.
I'm about to start my makeup. Honestly, I'm not doing anything dramatic because it's a barbecue. It's like a family barbecue, so they don't need anything huge. But I'm trying to... I am trying to finish the second episode of First Kill, and I really can't get to it. It's like, it is not intriguing me enough. Like, okay, light makeup is done. It's giving adult.
Hey, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'm really that girl. Yeah. But this is the outfit. Because, I don't know where to put this.
So I got this little top on, some jeans with some rips at the knee.
But then, guess, I didn't shave my armpits. And like, I can't be waving my arm all around. People I don't know with hairy ass armpits that like are yelling at them and staring at them. So we are throwing on this denim jacket, and it's windy outside anyway, so I'm gonna have a jacket on, but I'm gonna wear it like off the shoulder to be like cute and stuff. But yeah, this is the fit. I don't know what shoes yet because my toes are legitimately disgusting. Probably gonna wear these sneakers. Yeah, I am, actually. I'm gonna keep watching First Kill. I finally finished the second episode, and now it's kind of getting like a little good.
Happy Juneteenth. Happy freedom. Happy freedom. Ooh, child, I almost showed a titty. Mm.
Ooh. Ooh. Why you wanna, listen, this day is not for y'all. Child. Happy Juneteenth. Yesterday, I did end up going to the cookout. We went mad late on Caribbean time at 9 o'clock. We showed up to the little cookout at 9 o'clock, and it was for the girl's birthday, the woman's birthday. It was good though. It was a good time. Got some good food and a to-go plate, and it was nice being around older Caribbeans. Like, they're just such a good time. And it was chill. Tried to teach my boyfriend how to dance because he don't got rhythm. Poor thing. But it was really cute. There was like a moment, like me and Ian were talking, and all the little grown folks were looking at us, and they're like, oh, we remember when we used to be in love. And Ian and I were like, ah. Not us getting caught, like looking in each other's eyes and stuff. It was, I don't know, it made me feel some type of way. But it was cute. I'm about to do my makeups for the day. I still don't know what outfit I'm finna wear, but we gonna wear something. Something's gonna get worn. Yeah, my hair, I'm not gonna lie, like, it is giving me life. Like, I didn't get a trim yesterday either because she was like, you don't need it. And I was looking at my ends, I don't. The length retention this time around, I'm like really proud of myself. I don't know what I did, but I did something right. What I think about often is like,
We're supposed to reapply sunscreen. But how are you supposed to reapply sunscreen and makeup on? Like, is there like a sunscreen spray? I feel like there probably is, and I'm not. I just don't know of it. Like, there's like a little light misting spray. Kind of like a setting spray, but with SPF in it. Like, is that not available? Is that not a thing? I need to Google that. Alexa, next song. Yeah. I'm not happy with my makeup today. I'm not happy with my makeup today. I'm still pretty though, don't get me wrong. But I'm not happy with it. I look normal. Get away from me.
Still look good. The lash is still giving hella strong
Thank
today.
Thank you.
You went above and beyond on the lashes today.
Thank you.
Okay?
Thank you.
So you did do something.
Thank you.
Period.
Before we go anywhere, food. Food. Okay, it's giving. The lighting over there, I couldn't really see, but it's giving. It's giving. It's He's over my shit. But these jerk chicken wings and that one little rib finna give too. I just wanna say shout out to Cynthia for calling me just to say that I'm pretty. Let's look at the fit. All right. Oh no, my camera's gonna die, so I'm not bringing you. Shit. Welp, that was very short-lived. All right, we got some yin and yang gold necklaces. We got Black Boy Joy for Juneteenth. We got some denim shorts.
Okay, we're spending too much money. Too much money, they keep getting me.
We can't do this anymore. We're gonna have to go inside for the other part. Whoop whoop.
This is nice.
Yeah. There we go. Shiz. Came from the Afro Soca Love Marketplace, and we spent all of our monies, and I'm here to show y'all what we got, because it's a lot. So we're gonna start out with some beard system, right? And this is from Brown's Organics, where good things come naturally. That's actually really cute. That's really cute. We have a face wash, we have an organic beard oil, and then we have an organic beard butter. Okay? So all three of these is a system suggested to be used in the lock method. Let's go to the second hair product. So this is a mixture of what I got for myself and for Ian. So this comes from Banks Beauty. She was so sweet. I had the greatest conversation with her. So the customer service was there. So what we got there is Razor Relief Serum. And then, have y'all ever heard of a scalp scrub? A scalp scrub. I have not. So, got a scalp scrub, a Dead Sea Mud and Mineral Mask, and then a natural hair oil. So, this is gonna be on my next wash day. We gonna put this to use. Okay, and then next from Violation Necessary. He had to get some Naruto shorts. He had to.
They compression shorts too, y'all.
They are compression shorts, so he had to get them. Oh, okay. Your booty looking nice. Let me see your movement. Yeah. We are at Zoe's African Fashion
The owner is Bindu Dennis, and I got these cute ass pants. Are you kidding? The next brunch? I'm about to show out. How fun are these pants? Next, we have body beads. What is it called? Waist beads? I don't even know. But I had to get them because I feel like my body's gonna be out all summer, so I had to do it. So this is from Luvlee Treasures, your little piece of the motherland. And she actually gets these produced in Ghana. So this is the one that I got. So cute. Look at these. Like, come on. This around my little incy-vincy waist.
It's giving.
So next is from Pardon My Sparkle. Sweetest girls, the sweetest girls. And look at these hoops. Are you kidding? It's like orange bamboo vibe. Like, it's giving bamboo, but different texture, like see-through. Apparently she has some blue ones too, so I might go on her website and get the blue. Okay, next. Okay, this is really exciting. This is skincare. Okay, so it's Origine. Haitian women, and it's Haitian beauty roots. Like, come on. Beautiful women. They're very sweet. So, and the packaging, they really did that. So they had a three-step like skincare routine. So they had a mask, a hibiscus mask. So all their products incorporate hibiscus, I believe. It's like a clay. And when you mix it with water, it turns into a beautiful like pink purple hibiscus color. So yes, this is the hibiscus powder, and it's used as a cleanser. Okay, next we got some crystals, good vibe crystals. It was basically each one for $5, and these are coming from Pieces of Queen. And I got a handful of crystals for all different reasons. Not lastly, there's two more things, okay? Okay, this bag is giving the Jacquemus. I'm gonna say that. Y'all know what bag I'm talking about. Y'all know the really mini bags I'm talking about. Well, she gets these. Look at this bag. So cute. This is so cute. And the attachment that comes with it, so you could wear it as a crossbody bag. Super cute. This comes from Maryland's Adjure. Everybody want to have the little bags. I can have a bag too. I don't wear purses that often, I'm not even gonna lie. But when I do, I'm gonna pop out with this one, and I'm real excited. Okay, next is like a really cute top from Rock the Body Designs. And this top, it's like an asymmetric top. Love this asymmetric top. This is gonna be a brunch little number. It's open on the sides, and then you tie it around. I saw this at first. I saw it with this like in red, but then I saw the one in white, and it just looked clean, and I love it. We did get some juices from BK Juices. I got the gangrene, and then Ian got the watermelon one, which was really cute. This actually does taste really good. Oh, here we go. And here's the mad thirsty that this wasn't at the marketplace, but I got it anyway because this man dedicated in front of my building. He comes out almost every single day, almost sometimes rain or shine, like he's there. And I decided I have some cash left. I didn't use all my cash at the marketplace, which I was proud of. And I got this Black Lives Matter tee from him, right? He had more like African print things, but there wasn't anything called my name. But I figured on one of these days, on Juneteenth, might as well support him and get that. And I think that's it. Oh, and we got some oxtail before we left from the Trinidad. You trying to shout out oxtail? Might as well.
Might as well.
Alright.
Careful.
And then we got some oxtail, rice, and chana. Did I say it right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. And that's it. That is the haul. That is everything. Support black businesses. Support black people. Love black people. Hug black people. And happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there, especially the black fathers that are holding it down. Y'all are cool. All
right, I'm prepping to head back out there. Fixing the makeup.
You better do something.
Like the night, I'm ultra black. Sent for the sun, reruns, jokes are black. Oh yes, God bless success. We going ultra black, like the S is best. Hunt with a mask on, the freshest breath. African black soap, caress the flesh. Super fly the Mac, sitting fly in the lap. Take a boat on the water, history talks with my daughter. My son will be my resurrection. Constantly learning lessons, I never die.
Nobody's here. Nobody's here. It is literally dead.
Something is in the water.
Everyone is in something is in the water. Everybody's in the water. We are on the shore and ain't nobody here.
It's been dead.
It's been dead.
2:30 I've been here. It's been dead.
Shit. Now we're just walking around. We gotta fill our time some way somehow. They even little protest only got a couple of people. That's wild. On first view. Okay. Okay, it's a little bit more. Absolutely. Okay.
Wow, yesterday was cute. I mean, I had a good time, but I had a good time. I thought like the events I would probably go to would be more packed, but I figure that everybody was at something in the water, which is absolutely amazing, fun, festival vibes, but it just made the crowds a little bit smaller. So we went to some live go-go event on Freedom Plaza, which we thought was Mochella, but it wasn't. And unfortunately, the real Mochella that was actually happening on 14th and U got shot up. Like, why would y'all do that? And like, two people got shot, and seeing that video is horrifying, and it's sad. And I'm praying that the two people that did get shot are okay, because you go out for an event and you don't expect to get shot. So it just like, why would y'all do that? Why would y'all do that? And I've heard so many good things about Mochella, and I wanted to go. Thank God that I did not go, or I would have been running for my life. I haven't ran from a party of gunshots since undergrad. And I don't even think I got it in me to do that no more. You know? But, you know, I hope everyone made it home safely yesterday. I ended up leaving Freedom Plaza to go home, but then I figured I might as well just go to my boyfriend's house since they're doing a dinner for his father for Father's Day. It was real cute. Mama made lamb, rice, and she made a really good ambrosia salad. And I know a lot of people talk shit about ambrosia, but, and I don't even like ambrosia. At least I've had it like one time, and that shit was disgusting. Hers though, she knows exactly what she's doing. She knows exactly what she's doing, and that ambrosia hit. Had it with a little piece of pound cake. Oh! Mmm. So good. So good. I was so sleepy by the end of the day. So sleepy. I was basically hallucinating. And the whole entire ride home, when Ian was bringing me home, I was rapping. I was freestyling. I was freestyling with no beat. I don't know who lets me do this shit. And he was like, Fania, this is the weirdest I've ever seen you. He's like, this is actually very strange seeing you so tired and freestyling. So this is the end of this vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It wasn't too much. It wasn't too little. I am taking my day, my Juneteenth day, to actually work on the things that I care about. And I do like making video content. I do like recording stuff, and like, so seeing all the things that I've had last year, like recorded and just never posted, or over the year, like I record, I literally do. I just don't sit down to edit it because it's just like, I guess I'm just not confident in it enough to like want to put it out there, because Fania's living this life. Y'all really care about living this life, but you know, I constantly get reassurance that you guys do want to see it. So here it is. This is the end of the vlog. Like, comment, subscribe. Hit your girl up. Follow me on all the socials. It's WantaFania for everything. And I hope you guys had a great, amazing Juneteenth weekend and celebrated freedom for yourself. And that's all I have to say. Bye.